Purification is something very, very important in the eyes of Allah Azza wa Jalla. To the extent that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has classed purity among those whom He loves. Where Allah Azza wa Jalla says in the Quran, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ التَّوَّابِينَ وَيُحِبُّ الْمُتَطَهِّرِينَ. Ajib. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, for verily He loves those who repent, and He loves those who purify themselves. We spoke about minor impurity and major impurity, and today we're going to speak about something very common and it's something that we need to take into consideration. It is mostly to do about cleaning after urinating and defecation and the etiquette of visiting the washroom or the toilet or the bathroom, whatever you want to call it, restroom. I don't think we should call it restroom after we come to know now what's in there inside the bathroom or the washroom. We're going to point out the mistake that we do while we visit or while we go to urinate or while we go to defecate. This is something that we do on a daily basis. It's something that we really need to know. Trust me, things that I'm going to speak about today, you'd be like, whoa, for like 40, 45 years, I've been doing the same thing and nobody told me. No one will tell you because nobody goes inside with you in the toilet. Huh? No one can advise you. Something that you need to learn. And we're here to share that, inshaAllah. The place, the toilet, or the washroom, it's a place where in your house, this is the place where the shaytan resides. It's a place where the jinn stays. So the mistake that we do whenever we visit, whenever we go into the washroom, is that we just go in like that without making the dua before going into the toilet. The dua before going to the washroom is as follows. Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min al-khubthi wal-khaba'ith. O Allah, I seek refuge in you from the jinn of the male and the female. In that place, shaytan is there. In that place, you go there, you remove your clothes. And the way for you to be seen by them. So whenever you read that dua before entering the toilet, Allah Azza wa Jal put a hijab between you and the shayateen. They don't see you. That is why we read the dua before entering the washroom. This is the reason behind it. What if you entered the washroom and you forgot? Sometimes you can't hold it. You want to go into the washroom quickly. And then you get into the washroom. And then what? You're like, great, I forgot to read the dua. What do you do in this case? You read it inside in your heart. It is fine. You go inside or you forgot, you read it inside your heart. This is sufficient, inshaAllah. It is sufficient. And this is before going inside the toilet. And what about once you're leaving the washroom, the toilet, whatever, bathroom? What dua do you read? Simple. Ghufranak. Ghufranak. It means, oh Allah, I seek your pardon. It means, oh Allah, please forgive me. Why? Ajib. You know, when you are in the washroom, you don't make dhikrullah. Sah? When you are in the washroom, you don't make any dhikr. Why? Because in the washroom, in the toilet, you don't make any dhikr of Allah Azza wa Jal. But subhanAllah, because for that amount of time, you did not make dhikr of Allah Azza wa Jal, when you're leaving the toilet, when you're saying, oh Allah, forgive me. It shows you how important the dhikr of Allah Azza wa Jal is. Subhanallah. You know, we have dua that been narrated that whoever, you know, after when you leave the toilet, you say, غفرانك الحمد لله إذا أذهب عن أذى وعفاني. This is weak. Forget this dua. The dua that you say when you leave the washroom is غفرانك. That's it. This is from the authentic hadith. Before you enter, Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min al-khubuth wal-khaba'ith. O Allah, I seek refuge in you. O Allah, protect me from the jinn of the male and the female. And once you leave, غفرانك. That's it. O Allah, I seek your forgiveness. Entering the toilet with the left foot. You enter the toilet with the left foot. Basically, the practice of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and you leave the toilet with the right foot. Simple. Brothers or sister on the other side, trust me, these things, you think it's something small. It's okay. Trust me, on Yawm al-Qiyamah, you will know the value and the worth of those small deeds. Because this small deed that you're doing, you know, entering the masjid with the right foot, you know, entering the toilet with the left foot, leaving with the right foot, you think something is small. لا والله. لا تحرق قدم عروف شيئا. Do not look down upon any good deeds. ولو أن تلقى أخاك بوجه طارق. Even though you meet your Muslim brother with a smiling face, it's sadaqah. It's going to be heavy on Yawm al-Qiyamah. Entering into the toilet with the left foot, leaving with the right foot, it seems small, but it is heavy on Yawm al-Qiyamah. That is why the other thing that we have to do. Now we'll get a little bit outside of today's, of 21st century, but still we can connect it. Back in the days, or even now, when people go into the desert, sometimes you go in the desert and then you want to urinate, or you want to defecate. In that case, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what he would do, he would make sure that no one can see him, and he would go in a place where nobody would see him. And at the time of the Prophet ﷺ, whenever they would use the washroom, they would go in a place and nobody would see them. Like for example, if ever they have to go in a journey, safar, on a journey, and then the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ had to use the washroom, he would go all the way far where nobody would see him, and then he would do that because nobody is allowed to see your private part. But now, alhamdulillah, we have the toilet and the washroom. It's only you, no one can see you. You are free. Facing towards the Qibla while urinating or defecating, or but while using the washroom, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, إِذَا جَلَسَ أَحَدُكُمْ عَلَى حَاجَتِهِ فَلَا يَسْتَقْبِلْ الْقِبْلَةَ وَلَا يَسْتَدْبِرَهَا. Whoever is doing his needs, his urinating, or his defecating, passing out stools, then he should not face towards the Qibla or make his back face towards the Qibla. Ajib. Maybe we never knew this. This is Sahih Muslim, authentic. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whenever someone is using the washroom, let him not face the Qibla or his back face toward the Qibla.